The mushrooming of self-financing professional colleges all over Kerala has led to dilution in quality. So what is the way out?
Of course, the self-financing colleges, first we should have some sort of an analysis, a stock checking. How many of these students are needed? How many of these such engineers or mid-tech degree holders or professional degree holders are needed for the state or for the region? And then only after finding out their possibilities, the scope of the particular courses, new colleges should be sanctioned.
What about existing colleges? We have around more than 20,000 seats for engineering here alone. Do we need to shut down some of these colleges?
I think some of the colleges which are not performing, which are not, there is no result and all that, it should be shut down. There's no doubt about it. We should also understand, maybe the state has to check maybe during the last 5 years what is the position of the students who have passed out of this.
What level of employment are they
and
in?
And then when it comes to engineering, of course, in the medical profession, in MBBS program and all that, there's even now there's a requirement. We need more medical college, no doubt about it, in the area of health sciences. But in the engineering discipline, I think we do not require such number of institutions as of now. If you just analyze the engineering college results and the occupations of the students who are coming out of these engineering institutions, more than 70% of them are not doing any engineering work after BTech. They just go as medical representative or some
data
manager,
entry operator,
managerial positions. And it is, they are just doing only some sort of a clerical job, no technology input is there. So, but we need engineers. We need engineers in a very big way, but
quality.
Trained engineers. So what we have to ensure is that along with enhancing the number of colleges and the number of students, we have to ensure that good teaching is happening there. And then infrastructure facilities, state-of-the-art infrastructure facilities are there. And when I say good teachers, if you just look at the self-financing colleges, they probably build very big buildings and all that, lot of good buildings and all that, but there are not sufficiently qualified teachers to teach. So what is required is we start engineering colleges or such professional courses only after ensuring that they have the good educational and training infrastructure, and then good teachers.
Research is one of the pillars of higher education. What is the current scenario of research in Kerala? Is it industry linked? How do we make research more meaningful?
Kerala, the universities in Kerala, they are doing research, no doubt about it. But it's not much industry linked as of now. Of course, in Kerala, the density of industry is also not very high. Fundamental research is happening in all areas: humanities, social sciences, management, applied areas. All these areas, research is happening. But for research, what is required is we need a critical mass of people. In each and every specific area of particularly sciences.
Okay.
There may be one individual or two individuals doing excellent research in a few institutions.
Mm-hmm.
In order to do high quality research, particularly in core areas of cutting edge areas of science, you need
a team.
You need a team, maybe 8 to 10 people. Those who can collaborate, who can critique, who can also
contribute meaningfully together,
take up some work together. Such teamwork is very necessary, and this is particularly true for sciences and technology, and in all major areas. When we talk about research, now all over the world there are globally accepted parameters for for assessing the quality of research. So there has to be a mechanism in our universities and research institutions for continually monitoring the quality and quantity of research. Okay. And this has not happened. So that is the situation. But now I see a good number of institutions coming up with all the standard quality parameters in research, and there's a welcome sign.
Is there a need to restructure our traditional courses in terms of their teaching methodology, their curriculum, and so on? What will happen to our science and arts colleges?
Yes. Actually, in our collegiate education system, early specialization is happening. Mm. Too much specialization at the very early stage. What is required is an interdisciplinary understanding of, maybe if it is a science, for a science college, an interdisciplinary understanding of sciences. So similarly, there are mathematicians who are receiving, who are doing excellent biological sciences now. There are engineers doing excellent work in bioinformatics and basic sciences. So these are all, this is possible only when there is some sort of a freedom. For example, after plus two, a student cannot determine to which area he or she is really going to. Mm-hmm. So at least in the graduate level, there should be maximum
exposure to various disciplines,
and there should be maximum flexibility and mobility from one sector to another, one subject to another. That is the hallmark of good higher education. And then vertical mobility and horizontal mobility is necessary in all the subjects. For example, a student should be able to, a biology student, after the degree, taking a degree in biology, zoology or botany, he or she should be able to take up a course on mathematical biology. So if she or he doesn't study mathematics, this is not possible. So maximum flexibility should be given, choice-based credit system. All these things we are saying, semester, choice-based credit system, all these things should come. So the advantages of autonomous colleges is that these institutions can experiment this and try to correct themselves if there are course corrections needed in midway.
You hold an international patent for gram scale preparation of peptides.
Yeah, that's in the mind. Yeah.
Yeah. Will you demystify layman?
It was actually a new method for peptide synthesis devised by me and my group. It was a collaborating activity with a Swiss company, and you know, it's peptides are biological small physiologically active combination of amino acids. Okay. This particular peptide, even though it was identified, it was not prepared in a gram scale. So we have devised a new method, a new support for the synthesis of that peptide. Originally, it was one could detect that peptide, mm-hmm. but it could not be isolated in milligrams or even grams. Of course, these things are required only in very, very small quantity for the entire world. In this area. So we devised a method wherein this particular 4 amino acid peptide can be synthesized in a good scale, particularly in a gram scale. So we don't require it in much higher quantities, but even to isolate, and it was very difficult, it was only detected. So we just devised a method, and it was the work which I did after, of course, several years of After my PhD, I did the postdoc.
We would like to know a little bit about your family.
My wife is a professor of English. She was teaching in Calicut University, Mahatma Gandhi University, Kottayam, and last in Lal Bahadur Shastri Institute in Delhi. She was professor of English and director of women's studies in the university. She's with me in Trivandrum. I have two children. My son, Balanarayan, he's a PhD in chemical physics. And now he's in Technion, Israel, doing his postdoctoral work. He's married. His wife is also a biochemist, PhD in biochemistry, looking after some researching in medical biochemistry, a postdoctoral fellow. My daughter Gayatri. Gayatri, she completed her PhD from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, maybe 7-8 years ago. After that, she was for a short time in the Indian Institute of Science Education and Research in Pune. And then she spent 4 years in Cambridge,
okay.
University of Cambridge, biophysics unit. She's a protein crystallographer. Now she has come back to ICER Pune, and she's in the faculty of ICER Pune. Her husband is also a PhD in physics from the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Did postdoctoral work abroad, and he is an assistant professor in ICER Pune. So ours is an academic family.
Yes. Thank you very much, sir, for your very informative interaction and your valuable time. Thank you.
Thank you.